My name is John Passmore Edwards. I live between the 24th of March, 1823, until the 22nd of April, 1911. I was a journalist, a newspaper owner, and a philanthropist. I was the humble son of a carpenter, and was born in Blackwater, a small village between Redruth and Truro, Cornwall, in the United Kingdom. My mother's maiden name was Passmore, and she originated from Newton Abbott, Devon. I became the Manchester representative of the London Sentinel newspaper, opposed to the Corn Law. I was a Liberal Member of Parliament for Salisbury. I became the editor of a leading London newspaper, The Echo, which I bought in 1876. My publishing ventures had been failures for a time, but in 1862, purchase of the Building News led to profitability. This was followed by my purchase of the Mechanics magazine and a share in the Daily Echo. I eventually sold two-thirds of my share in the Echo to my friend and fellow philanthropist, Andrew Carnegie, to follow a political and social agenda. However, we disagreed, and I bought it back and restored the editor in 1886. The paper closed in 1905. I was a delegate to peace congresses in Brussels, Paris, and Frankfurt from 1848 to 1850. I stood as an independent candidate for Truro in the general election of 1868. Alas, I didn't win this seat, but in 1880, I gained the parliamentary seat of Salisbury. However, I became rather sceptical about the quality of professional politics and the inability of politicians to effectively represent the interests of their constituents. I twice refused a knighthood, and my opposition to the Boer War made me somewhat unpopular. A lifelong champion of the working classes, my name is remembered for being a generous benefactor. Over the space of 14 years, 70 buildings were established as a direct result of my bequests. These included hospitals, 11 drinking fountains, 32 marble busts, 24 libraries, schools, convalescent homes and art galleries, and my Passmore Edwards settlement at Tavistock Place in central London. I was also a generous donor to the Workers' Educational Association. Many of my buildings were designed by my friend, the architect Morris Bingham Adams, who was also the editor of one of my journals, The Building News. I also gave money to many hospitals, including Tilbury Hospital, next to Tilbury Dock in Essex, where I built a ward which was named after myself. Many of the buildings that I paid for are still in use for their original purpose. A bust of myself by Sir George Frampton was rescued from the basement of Hoxton Library in central London and unveiled in May 2007 at the Passmore Edwards Library in St. Ives, Cornwall. As well as London libraries such as East Dulwich and Edmonton, I gave the public library buildings in Devon at Newton Abbott's and in Cornwall at Bodmin, Camborne, Falmouth, Launceston, Liskeard, Penzance, Redruth, St. Ives and Truro. My Passmore Edwards Public Library in Shepherd's Bush, London, is now the home of the Bush Theatre, which moved there in October 2011. My legacy, I hope, will continue to live on.